Now, in the study of sex-linked inheritance or sex linkage, in yesterday's section, I gave the details about sex linkage in Drosophila, where I said about one sex-linked trait, namely white eye color in Drosophila. Now, inheritance of white eye color in Drosophila illustrates all the salient features of sex-linked inheritance which I listed earlier. Now, today we shall learn the details of this pattern of inheritance, sex-linked inheritance in human. Now, two classical examples of sex-linked inheritance in human are two types of sex-linked recessive disorders. One is hemophilia and the other is the color blindness. So, hemophilia and color blindness, these are the good examples of sex linkage in human. Now, let me elaborate these two sex-linked recessive traits and their inheritance in human. First one, hemophilia. Hemophilia. Now, this hemophilia is more commonly termed bleeder's disease. So, hemophilia is familiar, commonly known as bleeder's disease. Now, hemophilia in human is a sex-linked recessive blood disease or disorder. Hemophilia is a sex-linked recessive disease or blood disease or disorder in human. A patient suffering with hemophilia will continue to bleed even from a minor cut, even from a small cut, blood begins to come out, bleeds, and bleeding doesn't stop. It will continue, and often the patient may succumb, die due to heavy loss of blood. Now, this is a blood disorder, a blood disease, which is genetically established, which has a genetic base, and this is called hemophilia. Now, hemophilia, a sex-linked recessive blood disease or disorder, it is caused due to lack of two, what are called clotting factors. Now, the blood of vertebrate animals, it remains in its fluid state in liquid form, intact in the body. But when blood comes out of the body due to a cut within specified duration, blood becomes solid and plugs the cut end of the blood vessel, and that will prevent the further disaster and life is saved. So this is a protective property of vertebrate blood, even the human blood. So our blood within the body, it will be in a fluid form, in a fluid state. But when the blood comes out of the body due to a small cut, then blood will ooze out. Blood comes out, bleeds. But this bleed, this bleeding will not continue forever. But in a normal person, within prescribed duration, generally within 3 to 7 minutes, blood changes to solid. And when the blood becomes solid, the cut under the blood vessel will be plugged and no more further bleed, no more further loss of blood, and life is saved from disaster. Tragedy is avoided. Now here, this property of the blood to become solid when it comes out of the body, and blood becoming solid is called clotting. And in a normal healthy human, the clotting time varies from 3 to 7 minutes. Now for blood to clot, it requires certain clotting factors. Now in the human blood, it is said, it is given that there are about 13 different factors, and these 13 different factors are present in our blood, and if any of these factors are activated, they undergo a set of cascadian changes, reactions will follow one after another automatically, and ultimately convert the liquid form of the blood into solid. So this is how the blood clots. This is how the blood coagulates. Now, out of these 13 clotting factors present in our blood, if any one factor is lacking, if any one factor is absent, blood fails to coagulate. Blood doesn't coagulate. Now this is what that is concerned with this disease, hemophilia in human. Now one type of hemophilia called hemophilia A. Now this is the common form of hemophilia found in most of the humans. Wherever hemophilia is reported, it is commonly hemophilia A. Now hemophilia A It is caused due to the lack of, this is due to the lack of a coagulation factor, and this coagulation factor is anti-hemophilic globulin or anti-hemophilic factor A. This is also called factor 8. Now, when this factor 8 is lacking or absent in the human blood, then the blood fails to coagulate, and here the disorder is hemophilia A. Now, this hemophilia A, it has the history in Queen Victoria family of England. Queen Victoria family of England, the royal family of England, it has the occurrence of this type or pattern of hemophilia called hemophilia A. And hence this hemophilia A is also called royal hemophilia. Royal hemophilia, because this has the history in Queen Victoria family of England. Now, this queen herself was a carrier, and her carrier daughters have been married to other royal families in other countries, and hence this hemophilia is also being reported in the royal family of Russia and Spain. So even in royal family of Russia and Spain, there is the report of this disorder, namely hemophilia A. The another form of hemophilia, it is hemophilia B. Now, this hemophilia B, it is because of the absence of another clotting factor, and this clotting factor is plasma thromboplastin. Plasma thromboplastin, or ninth factor, factor 9. Now, this ninth factor, one of the clotting factors, this ninth factor is also called Christmas factor. Now, here the name Christmas, it is the name of a child in whom first the lack of this factor has been reported. This is called a Christmas factor, and hemophilia B is also called Christmas disease. Christmas disease. So hemophilia B is the other name, is Christmas disease. Now, lack of this factor 9, factor 9, lack of this clotting factor causes another form of hemophilia, and this is called hemophilia B. Now, this is a little introductory details about hemophilia, or the common name, Bleeder's disease, where a patient continues to bleed even from a minor cut, and such sex-linked recessive blood disorder or disease, it is because of lack of certain blood coagulation factors such as factor 8 and factor 9. Now we shall know about genetic aspect of this blood disorder, hemophilia. Now hemophilia is caused in human due to a sex-linked recessive allele. A recessive allele that is carried on X chromosome. Now here we shall mention about the different phenotypes and genotypes of individuals related with this sex-linked recessive trait. Now here, phenotypes and genotypes. Now following are different phenotypes. First one, normal female or normal woman. Normal female or normal woman. Now here, genotype of the normal woman. So here, XX. Female in human has two X chromosomes, sex chromosomes. And these sex chromosomes or X chromosomes will carry the genes concerned with the determination of body characters or trait, and hence the genes are called sex-linked genes and the trait is called a sex-linked trait. And here the sex-linked recessive trait in human is hemophilia. Now here, capital H is the gene for normal condition, and this is present on the X chromosome, and another capital H on this chromosome. So this is the genotype of normal woman. Now you can also write this as two X chromosomes carrying the normal gene. So this is how you can write the genotype of a normal woman. Now second, heterozygous. Heterozygous or carrier woman. Carrier woman. Now here, heterozygous woman is a carrier. Now I said earlier, a carrier female, she does not express the trait, but she has a recessive allele in one of her X chromosome. So here, heterozygous woman is called a carrier here, and the genotype of the carrier woman, one X chromosome carries the normal gene and another X chromosome will carry the its recessive allele. Now here capital H for normal condition and small h for hemophilic condition. Now here the genotype is heterozygous, because here for the character we have a pair of alleles, not a pair of similar genes. So here the woman is homozygous, and here she is heterozygous. And heterozygous woman is a carrier, as she carries the factor for hemophilic factor, but she herself does not suffer with hemophilia because she has the dominant allele, dominant gene for normal condition. So this is a heterozygous or a carrier woman. Now third, hemophilic woman, hemophilic woman. Now this hemophilic woman, the genotype is 2X chromosomes, and both the X chromosomes will carry the allele for hemophilic. So this is the genotype of the hemophilic woman. Now such hemophilic woman generally, such child with homozygous recessive condition for hemophilia generally does not survive. In other words, in human, the hemophilic woman having the recessive allele for hemophilia in homozygous condition, when the allele for homozygous condition appears, this recessive allele when appears in homozygous condition, this becomes lethal or fatal. That means the baby born with this genotype will not survive. It dies. So therefore, this condition is said to be lethal or fatal. Now, these are the different phenotypes and genotypes with regard to woman. Then with regard to man, normal male or normal man. Now normal man, now here in man, one X chromosome, another Y chromosome. Now this X chromosome, it has the gene for normal condition, but Y chromosome, as I said earlier, for sex-linked or X-linked character, Y chromosome has no corresponding allele. So there is no allele on the Y chromosome with regard to the X-linked trait or sex-linked trait. So this is the genotype of the normal man. So in man, one X chromosome, another Y chromosome, and this X chromosome carries the allele for normal condition, and Y chromosome has no corresponding allele. So this is the genotype of a normal man. Now one more. Hemophilic man. Man suffering with hemophilia. So here, one X chromosome, another Y chromosome, and this X chromosome has the recessive allele, the allele for hemophilic condition. So as a result here, because the Y chromosome has no corresponding gene, has no allele for normal or hemophilic condition, therefore in males, what the gene or the allele that is present on the X chromosome, that itself will make the trait to develop. Because I said earlier, in X-linked inheritance, males are hemizygous. So what do you mean by hemizygous? males having only one X chromosome, and this X chromosome has the X-linked allele or gene, and what allele that the X chromosome carries in the male, that will be expressed as the Y chromosome has no corresponding allele. And hence, in X-linked inheritance, in sex-linked inheritance, male is hemizygous. So these are different phenotypes and genotypes. Now we shall just examine some of the examples where different couples married, what type of children they can hope to have. Now here is one couple where woman is a normal woman married to hemophilic man. So you can easily diagram and you can find out, determine the children born to them, whether they will be normal or they suffer with hemophilia. Now here, what is the genotype of this normal woman? XX, both of them will carry a gene for normal condition, and hemophilic man, the X chromosome has the allele for hemophilic, X superscribed by small h and Y. Now here, when they marry, what will be the nature of their sibling? What will be the nature of their children? Now here, this woman produces two different types of gametes. Produces only one type of gamete because she is homozygous. Say the same type of gamete here, and we shall mention two copies of same type of gamete. Now here this man produces these sperms, male gametes. Now half of the sperms will carry X chromosome and half of the sperms will carry Y chromosome. Now when these gametes, when they undergo random fusion, they will have the children, and here the children are, when these two are fertilized, this will be a carrier daughter. Carrier daughter. She is a daughter, female, but she is a carrier because she has the gene for hemophilic condition. So similarly, again, same. Carrier daughter. Now when these two are being fertilized, this is a normal son. Here again daughter is normal, but she is a carrier. Normal carrier daughter. And again here normal son. So this couple, they will have the children. Among them,
all of them are normal. Sons are normal, daughters are also normal, but they are carriers. Now in the another example, a carrier woman married to normal man. Carrier woman married to normal man. Now here she is a carrier, so one X chromosome has the normal gene, another X chromosome has the recessive allele, and here man is normal, X has a normal gene, and other one is the Y chromosome. Now here this woman produces two different types of gametes. Half of her gametes will carry X chromosome with the dominant allele, and Y chromosome will carry the another half of the gametes will have the X chromosome with the recessive allele. Now here this man produces two different types of sperms. Half of these sperms will carry the X chromosome, and half of these sperms will carry Y chromosome. Now when these gametes, when they fuse at fertilization, the children born to them will be, now here when these two are being, when they are being fertilized, see, normal daughter, she is a normal daughter. When these two are fertilized, she is also normal, but she is a carrier. Normal carrier daughter. Now when these two are being fertilized, X chromosome with the dominant allele, so normal son. Now when these two are being fertilized, hemophilic son. So here all daughters are normal, but some daughters are normal with homozygous genotype and some daughters are carrier with recessive allele, but they do not suffer with hemophilia. Now here among the sons, half of them are normal and half of them are hemophilic. Now in one more instance where a carrier woman married to hemophilic man, then what will be the children born to them? Now here carrier woman, she has two X chromosomes, one with the dominant gene, another with the recessive allele, and hemophilic man, X chromosome having the recessive allele for hemophilic condition. Now here this woman produces two types of eggs. Half of the eggs will carry X chromosome with the dominant allele. The other half of the eggs will carry another X chromosome with the recessive allele. Now here these sperms produced here are of two types, one with X chromosome with the recessive allele, another with the Y chromosome. Now when these gametes when they undergo random fusion, get the children having the following genotype and phenotypes. When these two fertilize, XX, one X with H and another X with small h, so this is normal carrier daughter. And these two, when they fuse, both the X chromosomes will carry the recessive allele for hemophilic condition. So here, hemophilic daughter, but hemophilic daughter is not viable. This daughter dies because the allele for hemophilic condition in homozygous state, that is true in the case of a female, it becomes lethal, fatal. So therefore, this daughter is not viable, dies. Now when these two fuse at fertilization, this is a normal son. Now when these two fertilize, then hemophilic son, but here the son survives but suffers with this blood disease, hemophilia. So these are the children. So these are the different couples being married and what type of children they can expect. So these diagrams will illustrate the type of the children born to them. So this is details about one sex-linked trait in human, namely hemophilia. And another sex-linked recessive disorder in man, reported in man, is color blindness. Now, like hemophilia, color blindness in human is also a sex-linked recessive disease or disorder. I said before, most of the sex-linked traits are recessive and harmful. So this is very clear when we just go through the details of these two disorders in human. One is hemophilia, another is color blindness. So hemophilia and color blindness in human, both are sex-linked recessive traits, and both are harmful. Both are disorders. Now, color blindness, like hemophilia, is also a sex-linked recessive disease or disorder where the patient or the infected individual fails to differentiate different shades of color. So, we normal persons, we have color vision. We have the ability to differentiate different shades of color. But here, this is a disorder where the patient is incapable, unable to differentiate different shades of color. Particularly, red and green. So they are unable to differentiate these two shades of color. They cannot differentiate, they cannot identify red and green shades of color. But often they confuse these two for gray color. If you show them red and green colors, they fail to identify them, but they identify these two, red and green, as gray color. So this is a form of color blindness reported in human, and hence this color blindness is called, this is called red green color blindness, red green color blindness. So this red green color blindness is a popular form of color blindness reported in human, and this red green color blindness is also called Daltonism. So what is Daltonism? Daltonism is red green color blindness, and a person suffering with this color blindness is unable to differentiate, fails to differentiate red and green shades of color. Now this color blindness, like hemophilia, is also a sex-linked recessive disorder or disease. So as in the previous, we shall denote here different phenotypes and genotypes. As in the case of hemophilia, we can also write down here different phenotypes and genotypes. One, normal woman, and normal woman has two X chromosomes, capital C allele carried on the X chromosome. This is for normal vision. Second, normal or carrier woman with normal vision, but she is a carrier, that is, she is heterozygous. So in that case, the genotype will be XX. On one X it is capital C, and on another X it is small c. So this is for normal vision and this is for color blindness. So this is a carrier woman or heterozygous woman. Third, color blind woman. Now woman suffers with color blindness when she is homozygous for this sex-linked recessive allele. So here she has both the X chromosomes, and both the sex X chromosomes will carry recessive allele, the allele for color blindness. So this is the genotype of a color blind woman. But unlike in the previous, where when woman is homozygous for hemophilic allele, that woman, that female dies. Homozygous condition there becomes lethal or fatal. But this is not the case here. But a colorblind woman can survive, and she will be normal woman, but she will be colorblind. She will be normal like a woman, but she has this particular disease, namely color blindness. Now about the men. So normal man. So one X chromosome and one Y chromosome, and this X chromosome has the dominant gene and Y chromosome has no allele, because for sex linked trait, repeatedly I said males are hemizygous. Now here, color blind man. So genotype will be one X and one Y chromosome. So this X chromosome has the recessive allele, that is allele for gene for color blindness, and there is no allele on the Y chromosome. So here, when the X chromosome has the recessive allele, then the male will be color blind. If the X chromosome has the dominant allele, the man will be, male will be normal. So these are different phenotypes and genotypes in human related with this sex-linked disorder, namely color blindness. So after knowing the phenotypes and genotypes of different men and women, just like in the previous year also, you can diagram different matches, marriages, and the type of the children they can expect, that also you can indicate here. So this is the details about sex linkage in human, and here sex linkage in human or sex linked inheritance in human can be best illustrated by two specific examples. Both are disorders, both are diseases. One is hemophilia and another is color blindness. So this is an account on sex-linked inheritance, particularly X-linked inheritance, which is been explained with examples from the Drosophila or fruit fly and in human. Now some details about another type of inheritance called Y-linked inheritance. Y-linked inheritance. So hitherto that has been said is X-linked inheritance. Now another is Y-linked inheritance. Now in Y-linked inheritance, it is the inheritance of trait which is determined by Y-linked genes. Now in the earlier section I said X and Y chromosomes, like other chromosomes, like autosomes, they do have the genes which determine body characters. I also said there the sex chromosomes are primarily concerned with the determination of sex. Determining the sex, whether a zygote becomes a male or female, this will be determined by the sex chromosomes. And hence the sex chromosomes are primarily concerned with the determination of sex. But in addition, these sex chromosomes, they do have the genes that determine body characters. And I said such genes which are located on the sex chromosomes determining some of the body characters, they are called sex-linked genes, and characters are called sex-linked characters or trait. Now hitherto I described about X-linked characters and X-linked inheritance. Similarly, Y-linked inheritance, like X chromosome, the Y chromosome also has some genes. Now, Y chromosome being very small compared to the X chromosome, and hence the Y chromosome has few genes. Now, the genes that are present on the X chromosome, they are called X-linked genes, and genes that are present on the Y chromosome, they are called Y-linked genes. Now, both the X and Y chromosomes, which form the sex chromosomal pair, they have some regions homologous and some regions non-homologous. Now, the non-homologous region of the X chromosome carries X-linked genes, and the non-homologous region of the Y chromosome carries Y-linked genes. So, Y-linked genes, these are the genes which are located in non-homologous region of the Y chromosome. So, these Y-linked genes, Y-linked genes. Now, I said before, the Y-linked genes are also called Y-linked genes are also called holandric genes. So, Y-linked genes and holandric genes are synonymous. They are same. Now, these Y-linked genes, also called holandric genes, they are located in the non-homologous region of the Y chromosome. So, as a result, the Y-linked genes or holandric genes are confined, restricted only to the Y chromosome. Their corresponding genes are not been present on the X chromosome, very much like the X-linked genes are present in the X chromosome and the Y chromosome do not have the corresponding genes. And similarly, the Y-linked genes or holandric genes are present only in the Y chromosome. Their corresponding genes are not present on the X chromosome. So here, the genes that are located in the non-homologous region of the Y chromosome, controlling, determining some of the body characters, they are called the Y-linked genes or holandric genes, and the inheritance of such genes and their traits or characters is called Y-linked inheritance. But as far as Y-linked inheritance of characters controlled by Y-linked genes or holandric genes, this inheritance, their transmission, it is vertical. Because here, the Y-linked genes and Y-linked characters, they are directly passed from father to the son. So always from male to male, these characters are being transmitted through generations. But Y-linked character, Y-linked traits or Y-linked genes, they do not follow crisscross inheritance. That is what is true in the case of X-linked inheritance. So earlier, while attending the details of X-linked inheritance, X-linked trait, always X-linked inheritance is a crisscross inheritance. This trait will change the sex, that is from father to daughter, from daughter to son. So this will be the pattern of inheritance of X-linked traits. But as far as the Y-linked traits are concerned, it is not crisscross inheritance, but it is vertical inheritance, directly from father to son, from son to grandson. So like this, you know, it will be inherited, passed from one male to the next male, one male to the another male of the next generation. So this is how male to male transmission takes place, because always the Y-linked traits are being controlled by the Y-linked genes, which are the genes carried only on Y chromosome. So that is what is called a Y-linked inheritance. Now, a best example in human for Y-linked trait or Y-linked character is hypertrichosis. Hypertrichosis. So what is this hypertrichosis? This is a Y-linked character, Y-linked trait. Now here, in hypertrichosis, there will be a tuft of hair borne by the external ear pinna. Now here, this is the external ear pinna. Now in this external ear pinna, you have a tuft of a bunch of hair. Now this is a trait which is confined to males, and having a tuft of hair, a bunch of hair projecting from the external ear pinna, this character is called hypertrichosis. And hypertrichosis in human is a Y-linked trait. This is a trait or a character controlled by gene carried on the Y chromosome, that is Y-linked gene or holandric gene. Now this character, hypertrichosis, you find only in the case of males, not in females, because here this is a Y-linked trait controlled by the Y-linked gene or holandric gene, and this Y-linked gene or holandric gene, it will be passed from male to male. Vertical transmission or direct transmission takes place as a result. It is only seen only in the males, not in females. So that is some details about Y-linked inheritance. So both X-linked inheritance and Y-linked inheritance together addressed as sex-linked inheritance. So this is the details about what is called sex-linked inheritance, which encompasses one X-linked inheritance, another Y-linked inheritance.